Morena Jesu ke re dumelang and welcome to Mogadi Channel. Ke a tshepa gore o dutse o letile mme o nyaka go kwa gore mamotlhale ditaba ke tse dife mme tse e leng gore re a ithuta ka metlha ka gare go Mogadi Channel. Mamotlhale re bona sopedi sa go tuma sa pele e leng Sello Tshiko Tshwala wa ileng a tuma ka mmino wa gage ka gare ga South Africa le dinageng tsotlhe wa tsebiwa. Mamotlha re mmona a interviewa a bolela taba e botlhoko e mo diragaletseng ka bana ba gagwe. O bolela gore o ile a tsea leeto a ya kwa moša wa mawatle go bethwa ke moya gomme a sia barwa ba gagwe, ebile o mongwe wa morwa wa gagwe ke morwa o e leng gore o phela strateng kwa. O ile a mo iša direhepe ke o e leng gore o addicted ka gare ga dilo tse di drugs tse ke le bogodu ka gare, gomme o ile a ba beya fase a ba bontšha gore e bana ba ka ke a tsamaya mme ke sia lena mo lešhale le tlhokometse ka gae, gantsi ga a tsebe mathata a ta šala a tlhaga, mme bana ba ile ba sala ba mo senyetša mo ba ileng ba senya ba utswa ba rekiša dilo tša studio sa gagwe. Gomme o rile ga a boya humana le gore go senyegile, gomme o ile a humana go se botlhokwa gore a ka fitlha taba ya mohuta o. Taba ya e dirileng ko gore o ile a ba tshwariša gore ba kampane ba yo bolela kwa toronkono go na le gore ba ikhumane ba le strateng, gobane ge re le batswadi o humana le gore o tšhireleditše ka gago ka mokgwa o kampetše wa tseba go security, mara o senyetše ke bana ba gago, mme o humane le gore magodu ke ona o phelang le ona. Taba e botlhoko ye Tshiko a e bolelang, mme re tlo mo kwa gae yala ga e tlhalosa gore na bana ba gage ba mo senyetše ka mokgwa mang. Re a ithuta ge le batswadi gore bana ba rena mošo wa leswiso wa ba driver, mošo wa leswiso ba ntšhitše tseleng, gomme re tlhoka go ba rapelela bana ba gobane ba ikhumana e le makgoba a di-drugs le yona majwala le bogodu ka moka, mme ba re tlhoka e le bana ba rena gore re ba rapelele gore ba tswe ka gare ga maemo a go tshwana le ona a. A re ithuteng ka gare ga Mogadi Channel gobane morero wa lenaneo le ko rena le wena re ithute. A re mo kweneng ge Sello Tshiko Tshwala a di bia taba tse botlhoko tse e leng gore motswadi o mo le mo ke nagana o a amega ditabeng tse di jwale. A re thetse.
Stolen. But take me through that emotion when you arrived from the USA and only to find that some of your equipment was taken.
Well, as a parent, you know, it's hurting. You know, sometimes maybe it would have been better if it was criminals who jumped into your house and stole it. But if it's your own son, it's really hurting. It's not a nice thing at all. And you know, you have electric fence and everything in our houses. We have all those things protecting ourselves from criminals. Now you have all these things and the criminals are right inside your house, and it's your kids. It's really not okay. It's really hurting.
What did they take? What happened?
Well, I think it's on the 3rd when I left for the US, 3rd of August, I think the ransacking of my studio started, where my son was stealing whatever that he could see and sell it as cheap as he could to whoever that was buying my stuff.
So what led you to the decision then to call the police?
My son has been to rehab more than 30 times. I did everything. And he's my son, like I'm saying that, you know, I've tried to educate him about the good life. I tried to educate him on how to be a role model to our society and all that. But he never wanted to change. So I took this decision because I thought, as a parent, enough was enough. That's number one. I did everything I could to actually make sure that it's fine. And my son does not want to change. My son will talk to him today about his behavior, especially of stealing and taking drugs. And he will listen now, and tomorrow he repeats the same thing. So I thought, no, maybe this is the time now that he must learn the hard way.
What do you hope then will come out of this?
Well, like anybody, like any criminal who goes astray and they go to prison, and when they come back, they come better people. And that's what I hope. I actually think that maybe him being in prison, arrested, maybe charged, serve some time in jail, I think will come back a better person than for him to suffer in the streets and do what he's doing.
Have you considered to sort help or support from organizations or professionals for them?
He's been to a rehab 30 times. Those are professionals. So if he, those people couldn't help him. Remember, rehabs, they've got professional people who will give you all the assistance. So, unfortunately, nothing helped.
Were there any early signs, though, that he was struggling with substance abuse?
Not at all. Like I said, that he started when he was 18 years old, and then to date he's still taking drugs. I mean, more than 22 years. I've seen people having those issues, and then they come back to their senses and they stop. But with him, nothing has actually changed. He always lies. He's lying every single day. He's lying. No, I've stopped, going back and all that. So I think I've reached a point that, you know what, enough is enough. I'd rather see him serving time in prison than see him suffer in the streets.
And I suppose this has had an impact in the family dynamics as well as the relationship that you have with your son?
No, of course. I mean, everyone in the family knows, you know, and when he visits, my family members, some of them will hide their stuff and all that, because they know that the stuff will disappear. It's not good. It's not nice. I'm not hiding it. My son is a thief. My son is a druggie, you know. That I can confirm, and I won't hide it, because why must I hide the truth?
And of course, two of them appearing today. It's not just one of them. And I understand this obviously is stressful, but how have you coped as a parent?
Well, it's not easy as a parent, because these are my kids and I love them. They know that I love them very much. Hence, you know, I did everything I could to assist them. And taking this action does not mean that I hate them. It's just that, especially the elder one, Longwe, I want him to learn a lesson. Because it looks like it's one person who wants to learn the harder way. You know, the younger one, Silotwala Jr., I think it's the first time that he got arrested. It's the first time that me and him having these issues. I don't know how he collaborated with Longwe for him to actually be in the situation that he's in now. But when I heard from the helper who is a witness, he says the main culprit is Longwe. Silo was just trying to protect his brother, because you know how siblings are. So, unfortunately, I had to take action on both of them. But the helper says Longwe is the culprit.
And, I mean, again, as a parent, what sort of advice would you give to parents out there that are dealing with children that are perhaps having issues with substance abuse?
Look, I think it's very important for us as parents to really come out if we're having issues with our kids, you know. We've seen one of the SABC top executives, Hope Zinde, killed by her own child, you know. And I think because we're very silent and then we don't expose problems with protecting our children and all that, because once we do that, they will come and hurt us. If we allow our kids to go out hating other people and all that, and we don't talk about it, or taking drugs or doing all this, I think it catches up with us.
Thank you very much for speaking.